About the triple.
How do you want to go out in the parking lot and see if Katie's in?
I think she's pulled in, actually.
Now, red card.
Yeah, somebody did. Or you can still have the individual champions, but then the special award. Fastest. My daughter finished fifth in the mile at her sectional, at eighth grade sectional.
Did she?
Congratulations.
It was surprising that it's.
Well, I got 10 kids going, my seventh grader.
Oh, yeah. You're going tomorrow?
Yes, I gotta be there tomorrow on Saturday. All day.
All right. Oh, it's still not six, is it?
Yeah.
It's after six.
It's after six.
Right.
We're all ready? Rise, please, we'll do the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Roll call.
Margo Johnson.
Here.
Katie Johnson, here. Diana Mendoza. Nikki Pettit.
Here.
Tyler Wilson.
Here.
John Brotherton.
Here. Yeah, number two. The motion, would someone like to make the motion?
I make a motion to approve the agenda, removing and correcting items as presented.
Which items are we removing?
Removing items 10 and 12.
Okay.
I'll second it.
Thank you.
All right.
Todd made the motion, Katie seconded.
Margo Johnson.
Aye.
Katie Johnston.
Aye.
Nikki Pettit.
Aye.
Tyler Wilson.
Aye.
John Brotherton.
Aye. On to closed session.
I'll make a motion to move to closed session for purchase of lease of properties, selection of a person to fill a public office.
Thank you. Can I have a second?
I'll second that.
Thank you, Katie, again. You made it easy.
John Brotherton.
Aye.
Tyler Wilson.
Aye.
Nikki Pettit.
Aye.
Katie Johnston.
Aye.
Margo Johnson.
Aye.
All right, we are in close.
It does really mean everything you say gets picked up. Yo.
I told you.
No public comments.
You're already back in an open session.
Yeah.
And Hannah is going to note for the minutes that Diana did arrive.
No public comments, so we'll move on to number six item. Consent agenda. Tyler. Come on, buddy.
Thank you.
Make a motion to approve consent agenda items, including personnel report, as submitted with the stipulation that each individual is required to comply with all requirements for new hires as indicated in Illinois statutes and board and RCS board policy and procedures, including ratification of bills prepaid by the finance manager under board policy 450.
Thank you.
Thank you.
That's a second.
Second.
Thank you.
Moto Johnson.
Aye.
Katie Johnston.
Aye.
Diana Mendoza.
Aye.
Nikki Pettit.
Aye.
Taylor Wilson.
Aye.
John Brotherton.
Aye. Okay. Next item. Come on up, ladies.
All right.
Is it just going to be you, Emily? Yeah. Hold on. Come on to the table.
All right. You can sit with me.
Board, we have some staff members here from East Lawn. All right. I'll let you introduce yourself.
I'm Emily Stratton. I'm one of the school social workers at East Lawn.
And I am Melissa Wiggle. I am the assistant principal.
I think you should introduce your other guest. She's here, so the board knows.
This is Meredith McKenzie. She is another social worker at East Lawn. This is Rachel Palmer. She's a special education teacher at East Lawn. I'm going to take a second. Speech language pathologist.
All right.
So we just wanted to share with you something that we did a couple weeks ago with some of our girls. We had 10 girls participate in Girls on the Run, which is a national program. And the Y in Champaign hosts a lot of groups. But at East Lawn this year, we hosted our own group of Girls on the Run. And what that looked like was practicing twice a week after school, and along with running a little bit each time, there was lessons every week about things related to social emotional learning and basically trying to empower the girls and teach them skills like community building and how to stop gossip and how to work together as a team. And it all of the practices culminated in a race at the U of I, the Christie Clinic 5K race the girls participated in. It was about 3 miles that they ran. And they completed a community service project. They chose to pick up trash around East Lawn. So this picture is of them with all the trash that they found around East Lawn.
Oh, there were more pictures. I was supposed to scroll the pictures.
No, you're perfect. I guess there's 9 girls. On the day of the race, we had 8 of 9 girls participate. One was sick. And we had 4 coaches throughout the whole semester at East Lawn. We had an additional 4 staff members sign up to run with the girls because every girl has a running buddy. And so that was a lot of staff participation. But then we had a huge turnout of staff just come to cheer on the girls, which was really encouraging. We had about a dozen along the route, and then they all came and met us in Memorial Stadium at the end. So it was just a really positive school community experience with adults as well as the girls that did participate. And so that was really, it was just a really positive event. The girls were really excited to be on campus at the U of I and see how big the 5K race was. And they learned a lot along the way as well. So I just wanted to share that positive news. And this is some pictures from the day of the race.
And this is the one they do on Friday night.
Yes, yeah. This is the one on the Friday night.
Okay, well, that was it. Okay.
Yeah, that's it.
Thank you. All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right.
Good evening. I brought some students to talk to you guys about junior high dress code and specifically hoods in school. Last year, I know we had a lot of debate around this topic, specifically about changing the dress code and not to change it. And one of the things that came up is we needed to hear from students. So today I brought you students. They worked on kind of what they want to say to you, and I'll let them take it from here.
Hey guys. Hi, I'm LaVarion, and I'm in seventh grade, and I go to JWA day. And I thank you guys for coming here and tell you how we can look out for you.
Hi, I'm Amir Jackson. I'm 13. I go to JWA. We're here to talk to y'all about the hoods and the dress code. Hi, I'm Rashard Gardner. I'm in seventh grade, and I attend school at JWA. And I appreciate you guys. I appreciate you guys for your time, because you're amazing with us, for you guys to hear us out about the hood policy.
Hi, my name is Roger Brown. I'm in seventh grade. I'm 13 years old. I go JWA, and I appreciate y'all for letting us talk to y'all about why kids wear their hoods in school.
The first reason we came here to talk to you guys about the hood policy is that every morning that we walked in school, we get threatened that we're going to get phone call homes, ODRs, and referrals.
My reason is why we should wear hoods is because in school, it's always cold in schools. But we wear hoods so our ears don't get cold, because nobody likes cold ears. And every time we ask the teachers to turn down the air, they have a reason that they don't got permission to, or they don't know how to work it. And we need our hoods to keep us warm.
My reason, and I feel like the most important reason for us is when us students at JWA are wearing our hoods because messy hair days. Sometimes us kids might have messy hair, or we might not like the haircut that our parents pick for us. So instead of us being insecure, we might just put on our hood so we can feel less insecure.
That's us being young Black gentlemen, man. We feel like students can wear their hood.
My reason is people probably go through depression, or they probably wear their hoods to feel good.
My reason is that either, like, a lot of people like being alone. And if they had their hoods on, it's dark and alone. So if they have their hoods on, they're able to feel how they want to feel by themselves with their hood, and to feel, make them feel comfortable in the environment they're in. Any questions?
No, thank you for having the courage to come and speak to us. We really love that.
Okay, thanks guys. Are you gonna take off?
Yeah, right. All right.
And girls on the run, folks, if you leave, we won't be able to.
Okay, thank you for your time.
Thank you all for coming. So we did table or remove from the agenda items 10 and 12.
So we're going to go to number 11, authorization of deconstruction resolution. Dr. Wood.
I'll explain this one just a little bit. So the resolution, which we'll have it public on our board book tomorrow, in order for us to get the construction project done to open Rise Academy by August, we are requesting to forgo the bid process. It is allowable under school code that we are able to do this. It requires a 75% majority of the seated board members for it to pass. So what the resolution is doing essentially is authorizing authorizing the school district to move ahead with the construction project not to exceed $350,000. And as I've explained to the board, we anticipate having a firm quote in hand next week. And the reason we're doing this tonight is because of the vote threshold that is required. And for us to call a special meeting in June, potentially, it's difficult for us to, we would have to have at least 6 board members present for a special meeting, and that might not be able to happen come June. So as the board also knows, that we will have an opportunity to review the contract with the company prior to making any kind of payment. So, okay.
Any questions? Okay. Would like to make the motion?
I'll make the motion to approve the resolution approving emergency purchase of improvements to be performed in a leased space.
I'll second it.
Thank you, Katie.
Moto Johnson.
Aye.
Katie Johnston.
Aye.
Diana Mendoza.
Aye.
Nikki Pettit.
Aye.
Tyler Wilson.
Aye.
John Brotherton.
Aye. Move to information items.
Wow. There's the information items. The main ones I want to highlight for you is the FOIA resulted in 350 pages of emails, if you're interested. It's posted on the webpage. We will at the June board meeting have another tentative budget, or actually a budget amendment to approve. That was posted last Friday publicly. And then I'll have more information as to what we're amending. But usually at this point in the year, the amendment is just to reflect. For instance, we may have had new sources of revenue, and that is the case through grants, and also shifting money to the appropriate funds. Also, the school safety drills reports are in there. I'm happy to report that all of our schools did all of their drills well ahead of schedule this year. And we will be meeting with Ranchville Police Department the first week of June for our annual crisis meeting. So that information is in the packet. The next item is new business, if there is anything.
Okay. Ready for number 15, appoint new board member? Okay. Robin, you do it.
Well, we have to do the vote first.
Oh, we have to vote first. Yes. Excuse me. Sorry.
So we do item 15 first.
Yes. All right.
And then, okay.
Putting the cart before the horse. So, would like to make the motion?
Make the motion to appoint to the Board of Education for a 2-year seat that will expire in 2025. Ms. Vaughn.
Vote, unless there's a question.
Okay.
Oh, we need, I thought Kate second.
I didn't, I can't. I was like,
sorry.
Did you second? I didn't hear you either, sorry.
Sorry, Kate.
Moto Johnson.
Aye.
Katie Johnston.
Aye.
Diana Mendoza.
Aye.
Nikki Pettit.
Aye.
Tyler Wilson.
Aye.
John Brotherton.
Aye.
Well, congratulations, Ms. Vaughn. Now, Mr. Brotherton's going to swear you in the longest oath of office.
But I printed.
See, Tyler, it's not always on you, okay?
Okay.
Yeah, it starts off there.
Okay.
You.
Whatever.
Me, yes, we'll go together. I,
Robin Vaughn.
Do solemnly swear or affirm.
Do solemnly swear or affirm that.
I will faithfully discharge the duties of the office of member of the Board of Education.
I will faithfully discharge the duties of the office of a member of the Board of Education.
Of Ranchville City Schools.
Of Ranchville City Schools.
In accordance with the Constitution of the United States.
In accordance with the Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the State of Illinois.
The Constitution of the State of Illinois.
And the laws of the State of Illinois.
And the laws of the State of Illinois.
To the best of my ability.
To the best of my ability.
I further swear or affirm that.
I further swear or affirm that.
I shall respect taxpayers' interests by serving as a faithful protector of the school district's assets.
I shall respect taxpayer interests by serving as a faithful protector of the school district's assets.
I shall encourage and respect the free expression of opinion by my fellow board members and others.
I shall encourage and respect the free expression of opinion by my fellow board members and others.
Who seek a hearing before the board while respecting the privacy of students and employees.
Who seek a hearing before the board while respecting the privacy of students and employees.
I shall recognize that a board member has no legal authority as an individual and the decisions can be made only by majority vote at a public board meeting.
I shall recognize that the board member has no legal authority as an individual and that decisions can be made only by majority vote at a public board meeting.
I shall abide by majority decisions of the board while retaining the right to seek changes in such decisions through ethical and constructive channels.
I shall abide by majority decisions of the board while retaining the right to seek changes in such decisions through ethical and constructive channels.
As part of the Board of Education, I shall accept responsibility for my role in the equitable and quality education of every student in the school district.
As part of the Board of Education, I shall accept the responsibility for my role in the equitable and quality education of every student in the school district.
I shall foster with the board extensive participation of the community, formulate goals, define outcomes, and set the course for Rantoul City Schools.
I shall foster with the board extensive participation in the community, formulate goals, define outcomes, and set the course for Rantoul City Schools.
I shall assist in establishing a structure and environment designed to ensure all students have the opportunity to attain their maximum potential through a sound organizational framework.
I shall assist in establishing a structure and environment designed to assure all students have the opportunity to attain their maximum potential through a sound organizational framework.
I shall strive to ensure a continuous assessment of student achievement and all conditions affecting the education of our children in compliance with state law.
I shall strive to ensure the continuous assessment of students' achievement and all conditions affecting the education of our children in compliance with state law.
I shall serve as education's key advocate on behalf of students in our community school to advance the vision for Rantoul City Schools.
I shall serve as education's key advocate on behalf of students in our community schools to advance the vision of Rantoul City Schools. Okay. And
lastly, I shall strive to work together with the district superintendent to lead the school district toward fulfilling the vision the board has created, fostering excellence for every student in the areas of academic skills, knowledge, citizenship, and personal development.
I shall strive to work together with the district superintendent to lead the school district toward fulfilling the vision of the board, the vision the board has created, fostering excellence for every student in the areas of academic skills, knowledge, citizenship, and personal development.
Thank you.
Thank you, Ron.
No, you have to come sit up here.
Right next to the table. Sorry, but you have to sit next to the table.
Oh, that's perfect. No problem.
All right. And we are now to board slash superintendent comments, if anyone has any.
I saw something that I thought was very nice, that Sam, Paul, thank you. Couldn't even call. It's clipped my mind. Sorry. I just think of saying Sam. That he put on Facebook, my wife shorted Jimmy, because I'm not on Facebook, but my wife is, about what was happening at Broad Meadow. And I thought that was very nice that he had pictures about that. And they were doing, you could probably explain it better than I can, what they were doing with the third grade.
The dream.
Yeah, dream.
Yeah, something, yeah.
I thought that was very, that was very nice.
You're really putting me on the spot.
And I think we do, well, that's the reason I did that. And I do think that we are doing a good job, and I'll probably do better, about putting things out so the public can't see it on Facebook from all the different schools. And it's not like, well, it's always at Norfolk, it's always at East. No, it seems to be, all the schools. They had something really nice about Stronghold, what happened at junior high school on her retirement and her last band concert that she directed. And I just really think that's good, that we, because that does seem to be a major thing, Facebook and other areas like that. Social media.
A good way to get news out.
Yes. So that was my comment.
So my comments, J.W. Ader has the promotion ceremony next Thursday at 5, and it's at the soccer field at the sports complex this time. So board members are obviously invited, and you should have gotten an invitation. You did not. Other one is, we do have our three retirees. They were in the consent agenda today, but we have Ms. Copeman, who works in the cafeteria at East Lawn. Ms. Spencer, who is a longtime TA at probably lots of places, but right now she's with pre-K. And Ms. Jordahl, who I think has been here over 30 years as the band director, and retired once, kind of, and then pulled back her retirement so she could stay one more year. So
she is my band director.
I hope she'll pull it out. Maybe she, well, I'd let her stay if she wants to. But
that's good.
Okay, that's all I had.
Or anything else?
Two things. The play was cute, that I mentioned. Well, it was super cute, yeah. So anyway, I think they're continuing that program. So next year, I'm sure I'll mention it again. It was Winnie the Pooh, they had this little hat. Anyway. And then the other thing is, you know, just thank you to the teachers, staff. I know we're getting to the end of the school year and it's a stressful time and, you know, a lot's going on, but thank you all for all you do. And
yes, absolutely.
Yes.
My only comment is, yes, thank you for everything you do. And maybe if the scares us, if you guys are having field or whatever, if we could, that could be sent to us. I would like to participate in some of those.
I will let the principals know that.
Okay. Yeah. Please and thank you.
Thank you, Noe.
Mm-hmm. Well, Tyler, one last time.
Motion to adjourn.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
You just voted.
Yay.
Yes, you got the vote.
Welcome. Hi. Well, how are we going to do it anyway? Photo. Photo.
I know.
You got 5 minutes to cross town.
So, Ryan, come talk to me and Hannah first.
Come on, let's go. My family's going to be excited.
Or you want to come over here?
I'm going to.
A camera.
Camera.
What time?